on our long journey from the north to the south of the island, we tried to make a picnic next to a beautiful waterfall. But that was impossible, because it was pouring with rain. Our next stop, close from that point, are the Megara Caves. But here, there is so heavy rain that the complete parking space is free. No other tourists were here, so we haven't had to pay any entrance fee. The benefit of that weather was that now we have a really lonely place in front of us, really romantic. The only person we met was an Irish dog owner. And he told us that this is the worst summer he remembers. There are over 20 caves, 8 arches and 5 tunnels, which can be visited ideally by kayak or other small craft. After a 150-kilometer long ride along the coast and over small mountain passes, we reached Slieve Leak. At 601 meters, it has some of the highest sea cliffs on the island. In the evening, we visited a beautiful restaurant in Donegal and tried some salmon dishes. Very excellent. In the next morning, 50 km south of Donegal, we tried to climb up a mountain, the Ben Bulben. This mountain was shaped during the Ice Age, when Ireland was under glaciers. Originally, it was a large plateau. But as we are running out of time and the weather is raining once again, we decide to walk along the mountain edge, where there is a beautiful trail. Our next destination is Carrowmore. Here you can find one of the 4 major passage tomb complexes in Ireland. What is called a megalith? A megalith is a large stone that has been used to construct a structure or monument, either alone or together with other stones. In the evening, we visited the Cade Fields. This place can be really interesting for historians. This site is the most extensive Neolithic site in the world and contains the oldest known field systems in the world also. Nowadays, everything is conserved below a 2-meter layer of peat. Even on the seventh day here in Ireland, during the visit of the Ballycroyne National Park, the weather is rainy. But now we are accustomed to the fact, and we take it as it is. The most interesting place here is the beautiful visitor center. In the afternoon, we reach the Dullau Valley, and the weather become worse. We wait for some time in our car until the rain stops pouring down. Then we start to a walking tour along the beautiful lakeside. Due to the bad weather, no other person can be seen. We are pretty alone.